Well, it's that time of the year. Thousands of high school graduates are taking the next step in their lives. But for one Farrington High School senior, his road to Ivy League success has been anything but easy. Shawnee Barra has his inspiring story you'll see only on KHON2.
At first glance, 18-year-old Jake Martin looks like any other high school senior who's made it to graduation day. But ask him how he's gotten there, and he'll tell you a raw but very real story of growing up.
I'm from Ilocos Norte, Philippines, and it was a life on the farm, and we were one of the poorest families there.
So poor, bugs were a part of his everyday diet.
I remember them being really, really good, like they were probably one of my favorites, but thinking about it now, it was kind of weird, because all we had was our farm.
Jake emigrated to Hawaii with his family at age 7. He says watching cartoons in the Philippines helped him learn English. But his family frequently fell on hard times, moving more than a dozen times, and all of his 3 siblings dropped out of school.
I knew about going to college, but I didn't have like a goal set in mind. I just took it one year at a time, one step at a time, and I just knew that I wanted to do well.
That he did, eventually ending up at Farrington High School with a 4.3 grade point average and one of 6 valedictorians. His accomplishments read like a laundry list of academic accolades, but most notably is his choice of college.
I am in a full ride, and that's including the grant from Princeton, the federal Pell Grant, and my scholarship, so it is a full ride.
The DOE says Jake is the first student from Farrington to be accepted into an Ivy League school in 4 years, and possibly the first ever to make it into Princeton.
Is that what's required from English?
Yeah.
Angie Koanui is Jake's college prep teacher. She says his story has opened her eyes.
As I got to know him, I got to know a little bit of his background, right? First in the family to go to college, that his siblings, you know, get their GED or didn't graduate high school. So I thought, wow, you know, it's even made me wonder, like, how did he come with that, right? That value in education.
Jake's story of success in the DOE isn't the first and promises not to be the last.
We've seen more and more students who are from low-income families, maybe first in their entire household to go to college, and we see that they are succeeding both here in Hawaii and on the mainland.
One of my biggest fears is me going to Princeton and someone telling me, how did you get in? You're from Farrington, you're from Kalihi. But I kind of remind myself that, hey, even with a socioeconomically disadvantaged school like Farrington, I was still able to get my own resources, be an independent student, and get accepted to the same school as other private school students.
As for life after college,
I'll just go wherever life takes me, but I know one thing. I do aspire to start my own nonprofit organization one day, to make sure I give something back.
Shawnee Barra, KHON2 News.